you're anything like me, you have a thing for old, inexpensive motorcycles that have been upgraded to the hilt. Well, with the indelible support of my amazing patrons and producers, and after a few private tours and rallies in the books, I was very fortunate to pick up a new old motorcycle. It's a 1994 Kawasaki that is worth far more than the sum of its quarter-century-old parts. Now, if you remember the Frankentracker, you remember that it was also a 1994 Cow with the upgraded suspension, lighting, and the works. But this is not a tractor. This is the tractor's feisty little sister, Katsuki. Yes, Katsumi, a 1994 Kawasaki KLX 250, built in the time back when dirt bikes were still little more than a gas tank, a carburetor, and an engine bolted to a frame, and I was just sprouting body hair. For those of you who are familiar with this motorcycle, you know what it is and what it means and who built it. For those of you who are baffled at how anybody could be this excited for a 1994 KLX 250, let me explain. Like the nickname Tiny actually belongs to some enormous dude, the ironic moniker Mr. Duh Factor is paired to a mechanical genius.
So about 4 years ago, Damon snagged this clapped out little thumper for a song and wanted to rebuild it for his sons to ride with him. And if you followed the Chan Chan for a while and you know the history of the legendary Black Widow that he built for me, then you know Mr. Duh Factor and exactly what he's capable of.
Well, Damon put together a detailed series of videos documenting the rebuild, everything from how to buy a used dirt bike to straightening the frame to painting the rims to revalving the suspension and rebuilding a motor. And I highly suggest checking those out by clicking the card in the upper right corner.
Well, the short of it is, he turned this anemic little cowie into a bona fide destroyer.
He put in a 351 Bill Blue Big Bore kit with a fully rebuilt motor, oversized valves in the head, and flow bench porting from the legendary Lindsay Machine Racing crew in Salt Lake City, Utah. He threw in a Mikuni pumper carb for light speed throttle response, a DG exhaust system, replaced every bearing and seal on the thing, fully rebuilt the suspension with New Balance springs and gold valves, added a Tusk Street Legal Enduro kit, upgraded the stator for maximum power output, then fed all that extra juice to an 8-inch Racetech monster of a headlight. It's got a rebuilt 6-speed transmission with modern clutch springs, oversized Acerbis gas tank, recovered seat, new levers, handguards, Tusk handlebars, grips, and everything else. Over 7 months and hundreds of hours in the shop, it was a brand new motorcycle, and a far cry from the tame little KLX 250 it started life as.
So everything was going well, and then his sons became really busy with young adult life, getting married and stuff like that. You know, like you do. So Damon modded it a little bit for himself, but then he got back into the ridiculously powerful two-strokes of his day. So when room was getting scarce in the Duh Factor workshop, Damon posted it for sale with a friends-only price tag on Facebook, and our old riding buddy Molly scored Katsumi within minutes of his post for a screaming deal. Just $2,000.
And that's okay with Damon, though, because he enjoys building motorcycles as much as he enjoys riding them, and he demonstrates a humble mastery at both. Everybody who knew about Katsumi and saw that post was instantly envious of Molly and her newly acquired machine. Nearly every time my brother and I talked motorcycles, we would lament over Katsumi, The One That Got Away. And recently, while Kurt and I were blasting through the Badlands, both on Duff Factor-built motorcycles, the Black Widow and Kurt's Daisy Chain, which is a heavily modified WR250R, we remarked how amazing it would be to get Katsumi back somehow and have three of Mr. Duff Factor's fire-breathing dirt bikes all together at once.
So on a whim, I decided to PM Molly on Instagram and asked her if she ever wanted to sell it, and if she ever did want to please, please let me be the first on the list to buy it. And she got back to me within minutes, and she said it was just serendipitous, was the word she used, that I wanted to buy it because she was going to list it for sale the very next day. As fate would have it, Damon himself was already making plans to come to St. George for a shred with his awesome sons, and he was able to pick up Katsumi and bring her down to me, and we were both so pumped to see Katsumi back in the back of his truck again.
So to my brother Jay, our long suffering is over. Katsumi, this legendary machine, is back. She's a little worse for wear than when she was newly rebuilt. Her carb was a little gummed up with old gas. I could start her up, but it took a lot of effort and she ran terribly.
Well, it was just my luck that an old frenemy, Hermit Doesn't Vlog Anymore, randomly showed up to my house to hang out with his family in the Moto Mansion. So we cleaned the carb and made sure the coil contacts were all solid and adjusted the clutch. And now Katsumi fires up first kick. And I would tell Hermit that I'm grateful for his help, but after fixing the coil and fixing the carb, he took a poop in my boot.
Since then, I've been trying to harness the raw savagery of this motorcycle. Everything from the power delivery to the twist of the throttle feels very primal, but it feels very light while still feeling gorgeously planted. It's geared to tractor up anything, and the power means a klutz like myself can pop it up and over otherwise daunting obstacles. The suspension and gearing were tuned for the woods, but it does very nicely in this red rock jungle as well. In a single day of riding Katsumi, I've dared to do routes and obstacles that I would pass without a thought on my other bikes, even the WR290F Blue Angel. Sand is a non-issue, rock climbs are a non-issue, picking it up is a non-issue. Even kicking it over isn't so bad, because 90% of the time, it works every time.
That doesn't make sense.
I think my favorite thing about this motorcycle is that it's really simple. If you know me and follow the channel, you know that I'm a crap mechanic, but I think even I can stumble my way through most repairs on this bike, especially since Damon documented just about every turn of every single bolt in loving detail on his channel, and that means I've got an owner's manual in video form with an expert performing every mod assembled on the very bikes that I own and ride, and that is priceless.
Even though I love everything about it, from the way it looks to the way it feels, I still don't mind letting it fall over occasionally, or taking it in stuff where I'm certain that I'll crash. Like the Black Widow, it's a motorcycle that I will never let go of. I'll never sell it, so I never need to worry about how it looks other than my own aesthetic pleasures. And in my opinion, Damon not only rebuilt this bike to perform excellently, but styled this bike perfectly too. It's minimalist, no frills, no flashy graphics, just an enormous race light and an asymmetrical low beam just to pass inspection. It's all utility and yet so, so gorgeous. Is it faster than a modern dirt bike? Well, even though I'll set a ghost race time on it soon, frankly, I don't care. I'll never race competitively anyway. What I do care about is that the bike is reliable and it's simple and it's, well, it's a father's love embodied in a machine. Like a bullet train.
Moving like the speed of sound. Feet can keep on the ground. Can't stay in one place. Like a bullet train.
This is a motorcycle with a real soul. It was rebuilt by a very gifted man for his sons. It has history. There's nothing else like it, and in my limited opinion, it shares the podium with the Black Widow as one of the best motorcycles ever created. And if Damon or his boys ever want to take it out and write it, as far as I'm concerned, it's theirs and it always will be. They can think of me as the guy who stores it, registers it, and keeps the seals from rotting, because I'll be keeping it right here, gassed up and ready for them. I only ask that they invite me to come along when they take it out for a Badlands run. Like a bullet train. Like a bullet train. A titanic thank you to Damon for building both the Black Widow and this amazing motorcycle catsuit. Damon is a hero of mine in so many ways, from the way he treats all people with love and respect, to how he brings up his genuinely good kids, to the way he rides and the way he wrenches. He is a true example of love and service and genuine manliness and fatherhood. I also want to thank Molly for letting me buy it back and Kurt for making the phone calls that I couldn't, and Gabe for much of the excellent follow footage that you saw in this video. A huge thanks to everybody who has supported these videos and this channel in any way, from just watching the videos to using the links, and especially to those who have gone the extra mile to become patrons and producers, and to those who have joined me for micro rallies and private adventures here in the Badlands. Thank you guys so much, and much love. Ever ride out. Can't stop this train. I can't find the brakes on this bullet train.